No, growing to see the hypothalamus that produces the growth hormone releasing hormone. This goes into the pituitary gland and stimulates the growth hormone release. The growth hormone has by itself some actions, some direct actions, but also it goes primarily into the liver, and in the liver there is the insulin growth factor, well, it is insulin-like growth factor 1, and this is the most powerful, more than the growth hormone, and this produces other effects. There is also insulin growth factor 2, insulin-like growth factor 2, but the most important is the insulin growth factor 1. This is also called somatomerin. So, first, the direct effects of growth hormone are primary to change the utilization of glucose in the muscle and in the adipose tissue, also the protein synthesis, etc. Also, in the indirect effects of growth hormone, that is through the insulin-like growth factor 1, is mostly the increase in the chondrocytes, and again things like the glucose production and lipolysis, protein synthesis, etc. The growth hormone is a stress hormone, so as epinephrine, cortisol, glucagon, it increases the glucose in the blood, so it inhibits the glucose uptake of some organs. Also, it produces lipolysis. It produces also increased sensitivity to the lipoprotein lipase enzyme, and it's released in a pulsatile manner. Usually, in the day is low; it's higher in the night. The growth hormone also stimulates a protein or a production of a protein, that this protein is bound to the insulin-like growth factor. It's the protein that transports insulin-like growth factor, and this protein increases the half-life of insulin-like growth factor like 50%. So when we're going to test, for example, for acromegaly or TAT tumor, we usually measure insulin-like growth factor 1 because of its long half-life, or longer half-life than growth hormone, because the changes in growth hormone levels varies among the day very wet. So the things now that suppresses the release of growth hormone is feedback inhibition to the hypothalamus, that would be by the insulin like growth factor, also by the somatostatin. Somatostatin, remember, that is an enzyme that usually inhibits things. Not to be confused, somatostatin with somatomedin. And glucose. If growth hormone promotes glucose release, then if there is increased glucose, will inhibit the production of growth hormone releasing hormone. But also, remember that growth hormone is a hormone of stress. And so, when we have hypoglycemia, growth hormone would be released, and we will use advantage of this for a test in acromegaly.